Welcome to Field to Fork Cooking with Abby J. Today's program is brought to you in part by Ingles Supermarkets and the Ingles Table. Now here's chef and host of the show, Abby J, to introduce her special guest for today's show.
Welcome to Field to Fork. I'm Abby J, and I'm so excited to have Chesney McAllister here on the show today. And it's all about love February. This is our February episode. So glad you guys could join us and welcome to the show.
Thank you, Abby. I'm really excited to be here and talk about love and Valentine's and a little bit of the stuff that we have to offer.
Well, you're quite the entrepreneur. I mean, I met your husband and your family when they were removing trees. We have a lot of trees at Black Hawk, and you know, we have a lot of storms, and also, one of my trees that fell, Chesney, we made a my farmhouse table where all my fly fishermen have lunch. McAllister's did that for me.
Yeah, so that is actually where we get all of our wood, too, from, Abby, and we're fortunate to be in the business of trees, you know, and it ends up, we can do farmhouse tables, like you mentioned, but dough bowl candles is really what we're here to talk about today of what we were able to create.
Well, you started a company called Wicked.
Wicked
and
Candle.
And that company started here recently, right? Tell
yes,
us
ma'am.
How it started.
Yeah, so Wicked Candle Company started in October of 2021. And like we already mentioned, with the help of McAllister Tree Service, we were able to take some wood and carve out these gorgeous dough bowl candles that we see here.
One-of-a-kind pieces. Every piece is like crafted like a piece of pottery, right?
Yeah, it's different. So you have different grains in your woods that you'll see in each piece. And so each customer, when they order a candle from us, they're taking a little piece of the Northeast Georgia mountains home with them. So the wood is taken down from the company, and we then recreate it and reclaim them as these beautiful pieces you see here. So
well, you've done a fantastic job, Chesney. And I think that you, being that you're just getting started, tell them a little bit about the process of how they're made.
Yeah, of course. So we get the wood kiln dried from our sawmill. And once it goes through the drying process, we then put it into our shop where we carve out the vessel for soy wax candles. So we pour our candles with 100% soy wax. So they're all natural.
Oh, that's nice. So your house won't just...
No.
I remember doing that one time and my whole house was like black.
Yes.
We had to hire a painter.
Exactly.
You know,
and you won't have to repaint your house with these candles. You won't have to worry about that. From the soy wax to the wicks, everything's eco-conscious. So
that's awesome.
We love sustainability from the wood to that. And
well, can you refill these?
Yeah, actually, we have a monthly refill kit, or you don't even have to sign up on the monthly subscription. You can purchase a candle from us and then purchase a refill kit. Then do it for at home yourself, or send it back to us and we'll refill them for free at the fraction of the cost that you purchased the candle for. So it's a gift that keeps on giving. Keep on lighting your candle.
You're burning memories, right?
Yeah.
You're burning memories when you're burning this handmade, homemade, one-of-a-kind candle. Wicked Candles. So what else are you offering? I see these boards here. These are really nice. And, you know, this is really heavy. And
yeah, so this is actually some black walnut that we have turned into a butcher block cutting board. It's just one of the many other wood options and products that we offer here. So this is a great piece.
It's beautiful walnut. That's gorgeous. Look at that. Makes great gifts. That could make any kind of a housewarming gift.
Lots of our realtors are ordering these and putting their logos on them for that, and giving them to their customers. So they're great. And again, another piece that you can put into your home that came from your outdoors.
This is so exciting. And I can see your mind is going wild with all these different creations. I mean, you've got the heart.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
And how many scents?
Yeah, so right now we have about 30 scents. That's what we carry from winter, and then we'll change into our spring scents. And soon after Valentine's, we will start carrying those too. But 30 on average is what you'll see. But they're all special. If people had custom orders, we can even surprise them with some things that they like in other scents too.
So are you doing any wholesale? Like if I wanted to sell these in my shop, my fly fishing shop, Could you sell me wholesale?
Yeah, of course. So anything that you see here, we will sell at wholesale cost mm-hmm. to customers to see in their homes. We have a couple products across the county that are in stores too, but mm-hmm. you can always just find us on our website, mm-hmm. send us a message, and we could discuss wholesale and getting them in your
That's
store.
That's awesome.
Yes, ma'am.
So at your love being around all this wood, you've just come up with this beautiful, one-of-a-kind, wicked candle company,
yes,
right?
It's really fun. We're thankful mm-hmm. for it. We're thankful for our customers and able to give back a little piece of Georgia to everybody.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Georgia-grown.
It is
right?
Georgia-grown.
It's a
yes,
Georgia-grown
ma'am.
Piece
We're
of,
all about
piece
it.
Of a memory to take
yes.
home, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You've also got the jarred, if you wanted a jarred candle,
yeah,
right?
These are great, too. I mean, you can gather around these just the same mm-hmm. as this, too. We will even refill this, but these will be great for your bedside table or anything. Anything like that.
And then
gifts,
you have these.
Wax melts too. Everything is all the same product that you see in our dough bowl candle you can find mm-hmm. in jars or wax melts too. So it's great. And we're eager to even hear other people out. This heart bowl came from an idea of a customer asking if we would do any crazy shapes. And
yeah.
and that's the shape we
like,
came up with.
Like, what if I wanted a fish? I'm going to ask you, can you do a fish?
I would love to go to the drawing board and show
yes,
you something that
I would
could
like
do.
A fish candle.
Yeah, I
you
would
know,
love
that
to
would,
create
you know,
something.
And we could put little specks of mm-hmm. of like a brown trout.
Yeah, it'd be beautiful. There's mm-hmm. a lot of different woods that we could use that kind of mimic that. Mm-hmm. Rainbow trout or
See,
anything
I've got you
too.
Busy already. Your mind's going again.
Yes, ma'am. So we'll get to the drawing board with that too and see mm-hmm. what we can create.
That's awesome. So are you going to be at any shows?
We do plan on being at some shows this year. You have to stay tuned and see mm-hmm. which ones you can find us at. But we look forward to some summer and fall shows this year. Mm-hmm. Those are always a big hit for us. So we're excited to get in some around the county. Mm-hmm.
What do you like most about doing this?
Honestly, I love working in the candle shop and then coming home and smelling like a candle. That's great, right?
Yeah.
But most importantly, I love that we're able to give pieces to people that are affordable and that they mm-hmm. can gift their friends and love just as much as we do. So,
and making memories.
Right. It's
they
a
make
little...
a memory when you light a candle and
right.
you share those good times together. I mean, that's, will you have citronella because you've got spring and summer coming?
Exactly. We sit out on our back deck at our farm and we burn our candles. Citronella mm-hmm. candles, I'm so excited for. Keep the bugs away and enjoy a beautiful, you know, space outside for you. So it's great. It's exciting mm-hmm. to see people love these mm-hmm. as much as we do.
Yeah.
And we're excited to see what's to
well,
come.
Well, this is a special line. I'm so proud
yes.
of you. And, you know, this is my candle. I thank
yes.
you so much.
Yes,
and,
this
you
is...
know, I just think that, you know, the sky's the limit for
you,
you in this product line, and I'm so proud of you for
Thank
your
you.
Endeavors to go out, step outside the box a little
yes,
bit, because that's what you've done here, mm-hmm. because there's nothing like this.
We're excited, and we think mm-hmm. it's fun, too, and I hope that you love this, and I hope whoever purchases these heart and square and other candles, that they love them just as much as we do too.
Well, we're going to come back and we're going to burn a candle.
Okay.
And we're going to talk about the Ingalls table and we might make a little something to go along with this candle.
That sounds perfect. I'd
so
love that.
We'll be right back.
At Ingalls, we have a very special family. A family of farmers, ranchers, and dairymen. Clerks, butchers, and bakers. Deli workers, pharmacists, and florists. We work hard every day to bring you the very best, and we'll continue to wake up every morning and work as hard as you do. This is our town, and we built this community together. Ingalls, your neighbor for over 50 years.
Welcome back.
Well, Abby, what are we doing now?
Well, I know you've got these beautiful candles and we're just setting the scene for romance. So we got to make something.
Yeah.
And you know, and I've got this really puff pastry berry tart. You can get these. This is so easy to do. It's a puff pastry shell.
I love that.
And you have to cook these for
okay.
about 18 or 20 minutes. And then what you do is you just take the middle out here so you've got some space to
okay.
stuff them. And these are the little tops. So what I did, I got this, this is a blueberry lime preserve. And they make this at Hillside Orchards,
oh,
my co-packer.
Wonderful, yes.
But you could use my habanero peach. But since it is... Valentine's, we want to stick with the berries.
Sure, yes.
So what I did was I got some mixed fruit.
Okay.
And that's some of my favorites, raspberries, strawberries. You add the blueberry preserves. You melt this and you get this all combined so it's together. And it's so easy. And it makes a beautiful dessert.
Yeah, this looks delicious. What do you do after you start mixing this up?
So you take the shell and you just want to fill these like so. Let me get this up here. And we'll do a little another berry.
I love that.
See this?
Mm-hmm.
And to top it off, I'll go ahead and show you like this.
Oh my
and
gosh.
And then I got some fresh raspberries.
To go right on top.
And there you have it. Isn't that beautiful? Let's make a couple of more.
Yeah. I hope somebody makes these for my Valentine's.
You know, you've got a husband. You can go home.
Maybe I'll make a for
I mean, how quick and simple is this?
They look delicious. And they might get eaten before they make it to the table.
Right. And there.
I love that. Well, perfect. Let's make a couple more.
There we go. And this is so versatile. You can use any kind of berries, but this says Valentine's all day long.
Yes.
Don't you think?
I agree.
And strawberry season's going to be in soon, so just whip it. And you could even do some chocolate shavings on it.
Oh, yeah, that would be cute, too. I love the berries, though. I think
the raspberries kind of look heart-shaped.
Mm-hmm.
The fresh ones, I always use fresh on top, though. These have got the preserves, and it kind of keeps all the other berries together. So go like that.
I love it. I think
that one needs two. Oh, one fell
off.
There we go. There we go. And if you wanted to put the little cap, you could. But, you know, I really like it the way it is without the cap.
I think so, too. I love it.
So we'll do one more. I think you got the hang of this. And see, what a wonderful way. And there's the candle.
I know. This would be so romantic.
One more. And there you have it. What a wonderful way to, you know, create a little treat for someone.
Yeah.
And these are great for brunch. You could have them, you know, for any dessert, you know, after steak dinner or whatever.
They're perfect. They're light and they're easy to make. I mean, you just made those in a few seconds. Yeah, that's perfect.
Exactly.
I love that, Abby.
Exactly. So we'll be right back to talk about the Ingalls table.
Here at Ingalls, we know that you're probably cooking from home a little more than usual these days, so we have assembled an amazing collection of easy-to-prepare recipes. Join us at the Ingalls table at ingalls-markets.com.
Welcome back to Field of Fork, and I'm so honored to represent the Ingalls Table magazine. This magazine you can find at our deli department. It makes your life easy with great recipes from all of our featured chefs. So make sure you get by there. We have a copy of every season. Like we've just come out with a winter edition. So make sure you get by there and get that. It really does make your life easier. And so the other special offerings, the floral department, for Valentine's, you can go by there and get this beautiful bouquet of roses. They do a great job with all their floral pieces. And also we have the bulbs and the little cut roses. These are great little items to pick up because you can, they last after the season. And just for fun, if you just want to pick up a little box of candy, these make great little teacher gifts, whatever, if you just want to make someone feel special. These are really great. And they have a whole assortment of other chocolates and also cookies in the bakery. This is Leonard's Valentine's variety pack. This is great. And of course, you know, don't forget these candles. Chesney McAllister came out today, and I just really love what she offered. And we're going to go on a road trip right now, and we're going to go show you a great dining experience for Valentine's. So let's go.
Don't go away. More Field of Fork Cooking with Abby J and her guest. We'll be right back.
Do more. Enjoy more. Expect more from your internet experience. Kinetic by Windstream is delivering enhanced speed and reliability for homes and businesses around the country. We've made major investments in our network in your community. We're lighting the way to advanced capabilities and more opportunities. Stream seamlessly, surf securely, game victoriously, and connect to great offers for work or home at Windstream.com.
Welcome back to Field to Fork, and I'm Abby J, and we are so happy to be in downtown Cornelia at a new establishment, Community Brew and Tap, with the owner, Melissa Reeder. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And tell us about how this got started.
So we bought this building a few years ago. It kind of sat empty and it was gutted, and we weren't quite sure what we were going to do with it. And Jay, my husband, decided a restaurant. So lo and behold, here we are, and it's beautiful. We've only been open a few months.
This used to be the Community Bank and Trust, right? And there's still a vault here, right?
There are. There are actually four vaults, and you get to walk through one in the upstairs dining room and one in the downstairs.
And you really gave it a whole new look by and discovered there was brick.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. We had plaster on this wall, and they chipped away at it, and it's this beautiful wall that's been here for many, many, many years. So we wanted to really lend that and let it speak to us in the speakeasy that we've created.
Absolutely. And tell us, where did you come up with the concept of this whole establishment? Because it's fantastic. You have some wonderful offerings, and I'm just happy to know that it's here.
Thank you so much. Jay wanted a speakeasy, Prohibition era type restaurant, and really our biggest thing was to have people to quit driving to Atlanta. You can stay here locally in Habersham and dine and hang out and be close to home. And so that was kind of his dream and his vision. And he had a great team of people that we have here and some that are still here part-time, and they kind of just ran with the vision, and we made it happen. So,
well, I know Habersham, we needed this, right?
Yes, we're excited to be here.
And you've got a lot of things like this beautiful bar back here. Tell us about some of the cocktails and who's doing some of these things.
We have two incredible bartenders, Carson and Eddie, and they put together some of the best craft cocktails that you will taste. Some of them have smoke, some of them have bubbles, so they make it a lot of fun, and they're super delicious.
Well, I was here one night, and I was blown away. I mean, you've got dried fruit. You've got all kinds of things that, you know, you don't normally see in an establishment unless you go to Atlanta, Melissa. And and I commend you on upscaling. This is a very upscale restaurant, but affordable, right?
Yes, it is. And also, when you talk about the dried fruit, these guys take total pride in all that they do. They literally dry all of that themselves, and so they want all of it to be super special and bring, like you said, Atlanta here in Habersham County.
Well, it inspired me so much. I went home and I dried my own fruit. I sugared some fruit.
I love it.
Because I was like, I can do this. I can do this. I got to have this at home too.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
It was so good. So let's talk about the chef and some of the offerings, the food offerings.
Okay. So our chef is Chef Jason Vulo, and he is phenomenal. He came from Rathbun Steakhouse, and he is here. He creates some spectacular dishes that you will love.
And if you guys have not been down here, you need to try it. And we're going to go back and talk to the chef and look at some of those offerings. So let's go.
All right.
Okay, we're back in the kitchen, Melissa. And who is your chef?
We are honored to have Chef Jason Vulo.
Jason Vulo, hi.
Hey, how are you today?
I'm great. I'm Abby J. And we want to see what the magic is here at Community Brew and Tap.
All right. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to do a beef tartare, but we're going to present ours a little bit different. We're going to be doing ours on a roasted piece of bone marrow that we're going to sear off on the grill. And so what we have right here is we have a little bit of our prime New York that we have cut, pickled mustard seeds, toasted Benny seeds, some shallots and chives. We also have our barrel smoked soy vinaigrette and a white truffle miso emulsion here.
Well, I can smell those flavors from here.
All right.
And I can't wait to see you put this together. So let's get with it.
All right, excellent. So let's start out. We're gonna combine our mints, take some of our chives, some of our shallots.
It's all about the flavor, right?
All about layering the flavors, making sure that there's different contrast of textures.
Right.
Here's some of the toasted seeds. Now we're going to mix in some of our vinaigrette. So at this point, we're just looking to really combine it very well, making sure all our spices and seasonings have coated absolutely everything. And that's looking great. So at this,
that looks awesome.
Well, thank you. At this point, I'm going to go over to the grill and get this bone finished, and then we'll be right here to put it all together.
Okay, Jason, we're going to be right back and look at your final version of these beautiful dishes, okay?
Wonderful. Thank you.
Don't go away. More Field of Fork Cooking with Abby J and her guest. We'll be right back.
Do more. Enjoy more. Expect more from your internet experience. Kinetic by Windstream is delivering enhanced speed and reliability for homes and businesses around the country. We've made major investments in our network in your community. We're lighting the way to advanced capabilities and more opportunities. Stream seamlessly, surf securely, game victoriously, and connect to great offers for work or home at Windstream.com.
All I can say is, wow, you've outdone yourself here, Jason.
Well, thank you.
What did you do here?
So right here we have our grilled roasted bone marrow with our tartare. It's got a little bit of pickled mustard seeds, the truffle miso aioli on there. And right here, this beautiful 12-ounce filet. We've grilled it. We've sliced it. Now let's finish it up real quick. We're going to take some of our house leek seasoning. This is a very special spice. It takes almost 24 hours to prepare it. We're going to just lightly top it like that. We have this cloche, and now's the moment of truth. We're actually going to be smoking this with hickory smoke. And as you can see, it's filling up the plate with all that beautiful aroma.
You know what? It's smoking hot here at Community Brew and Tap, and it looks so delicious.
Well, thank you. Well, I think it's about ready. It's smoked long enough. And the beautiful thing about this steak is when we take it to our guests, we bring it right out like this and presenting it. And so the smoke is not only flavoring the steak, but it's a beautiful perfume for the room as well.
You did a beautiful job on both of those, and what great offerings that Community Brew and Tap has for everyone to come and share. I could share that with my husband. I don't eat a big steak, but this looks beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
It's a pleasure for having us here today.
Thank you.
All right. We'll be right. Melissa, this has been a fabulous experience, and I want to thank you for having us come by and enjoy Community Brew and Tap.
Thank you so much. We're so excited to have you guys here.
And it's, you know, when I first came here, I got to experience happy hour with Carson. Yeah. And I think it's every hour happy hour with
Absolutely.
Carson, don't you?
He makes it a lot of fun every single day. He does.
What's your favorite drink?
Oh, my gosh. Probably the old cherry tree.
Well, why don't we toast?
Yes.
And here's to Community Brew and Tap. We hope you all come out and check it out. It's awesome. Cheers.
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 thanks so much for joining us for today's program. We look forward to having you back next time on Field to Fork Cooking with Abby J. This program is brought to you in part by Ingles Supermarkets and the Ingles Table, and is a video production of Kinetic TV.